I know them kids love their dad, though. Mm-hmm. They love their dad. That's the worst thing that hurt me. To see, you know, my baby. He literally jumped on his casket and was like, wake up.
For real?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he didn't know what's going on. Like, he didn't cry or anything, but.
Which one was the oldest or the youngest? Oldest one.
Mm-hmm. And then my baby, like, he stood there until they put Eugene on the ground and everything. He moved and told his daddy goodnight. So at that moment, I think he understood because he didn't even want to leave the grave site. Mm-hmm. He said he wanted to stay there. He wanted to stay with his daddy. But he couldn't stay with his daddy.
Again, this is another Black Brother production. Right now, we're not even focused on that right now. We're going to go ahead and focus on the issues at hand. Recently, you know, one of my Jonesy brothers was found, you know, dead in Southside or whatever. And they're searching, you know, trying to figure out who did it or who was the killer and all that type of stuff, man. So the whole city is kind of like messed up about it right now. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and introduce the mother of his children, Miss Elmeria Devoe Mitchell. How you doing, Miss Elmeria?
I'm fine.
All right. Now, I want you to just give us a little bit of insight on you know, what you know about the situation or what happened about the situation.
Well, all I know is I got a phone call about 4 o'clock that morning. And at that time, it was a possibility that it could be him. So he was like, okay, it's Eugene Brown. So he's like, okay, it's a possibility that it could be him. But then I kept calling and calling. I was answering the phone. He was hanging up. And I could call back. And instantly I knew it was him. So basically all the information I got to say he's found laying in the street. Shot multiple times. One bullet killed him, but he was shot multiple times. Mm-hmm. And basically they're still investigating, trying to figure out who the individuals are. And I do mean individuals. It's not one person. It's more than one person.
Wow.
So, that's basically everything I'm waiting on. Just want a little closure. Just want to, you know, find out who that person was. And I want to know who gave them the right to just take my kid's dad away from them. You know, because our relationship, typical baby mom, baby dad relationship, but at the end of the day, we put them kids first. And the kids love their daddy. So, now I'm just going to have to spend the rest of my life and the rest of their life just explaining to them, you know, such and such and such happened to daddy. Because right now, daddy just sleep. But when they get old enough and they have a lot of, you know, a lot more sense, I'm going to have to explain to them, okay, this is what happened to daddy, and I'm going to have to deal with their hurt. Because when your kids hurt, you hurt. So I just want to get a little closure. I just want to know who did it and just move forward.
And this is actually happening way too much in the city of Augusta, man. We've had like 2 or 3 of the same type of issues, man. So we definitely want this to stop. We want to stop the violence and all that, man. That's why we definitely wanted to touch on this situation, man. It's real rough right now. Like, you know, how are you really taking it? Like, have you took some time to yourself and actually took it in, or is it still like unrealistic right now?
Sometimes I feel like, no, okay, I'm gonna say this. In the beginning when it first happened, it didn't seem like it was real. It was real on Tuesday, though, when I seen him just laying there. Mm. And my kids seen daddy wake up, and he wasn't going to wake up. So, I mean, I had to watch my son tell his daddy goodnight. Mm. And he didn't even know why he was telling him goodnight. So, I mean, it's a hard pill to swallow, but I think I'm taking it a lot better than I thought I ever would. But it's all because of my children. My children give me the strength. I have to be strong for them. You know, I can't walk around and mope and be crying. And, you know, because I have to explain that to them. Like, what's going on? It's too little for that. It's too little that I want to expose them for too much. But, I don't know, it's going to be a process trying to get over it and trying to cope. But it'll be all right.
Augusta, we definitely want to stop these senseless killings and just, we really want to come together, man. We got to stop all this violence against each other and all that, man, against everybody, man. It's all of it is just, it's too much. You get what I'm saying? And at this point, man, we definitely trying to find more information. If anybody has any information on what happened to Eugene, man, in Southside, man, we asking the people to come forward, man, and you know, so you can give the mother of his children some closure and some closure for his kids at the same time. So I want you to just look into the camera, Amelia, and just, you know, if the people looking at it, you know, who did it or know something about it, just kind of talk to them and tell them, you know, how you feeling, like, and just ask them, you know, they have any type of information, like contact you or contact the sheriff department, anything like that.
Basically, put yourself in my shoes. And I'm raising boys at that, so who will teach my sons to be men? I'm a woman. I can work my ass off to say, hey, you gotta do such and such and such. A man does this and does that, but only a man can teach a young boy how to be a man. So you took that opportunity away from my kids. So just give me that respect enough. Even if you want to remain anonymous, I don't care. But you go to the investigators and you let them know what you know so that me and my family can move forward. And so, you know, as well as Virginia, you know, because she's pregnant with his child. Like, this man got two children and another child on the way. And it's not fair to neither one of us to have to deal with that for the rest of their life. No one deserved that at the end of the day. Gene wasn't that bad of a dude for you to sit and just put a bullet in his head when he had a family to raise. Simple.
So if y'all have any information, man, y'all contact the sheriff department, or man, tell somebody to tell somebody, man, if you want to remain anonymous or anything like that, man. We definitely trying to get closure for the family and for the city of Augusta, man. Again, this gotta stop, man. We are.
From me.